Hello, my name is Dr. Roland Owen. I'm a GP in Highfields near Toowoomba. So you've got an elderly patient with confusion. This is a really difficult subject and can be quite daunting to handle. It really depends on where the patient is. Are they at home on their own? Have they got carers? Are they in a nursing home? How quickly has this condition come on? Is it gradual? Is it sudden worsening? This is a huge subject. We'll start off again with a pragmatic approach. Where do we go from here? So first up, assessing whether this is acute or chronic. Is this acute confusion or is this a delirium? Is this due to a treatable reversible condition? That's probably the battles to pick and choose. That's the one we can do something about. So in that context, trying to work out what you know about past medical history, see if you can get one from the patient. And obviously with confusion, that's quite hard. So from the carers, family, nurses around them. Get a good medical history, get a medication history, find out what they're taking. Is there any interaction from medication, some polypharmacy? Has there been any recent changes in medications? That's always a great, simple starting point that sometimes a change in the last few weeks could have set things off, tipped things over the balance. And just by changing things back, you can save a lot of problems and also be quite efficient in managing this problem. Now, the more complicated issues, you've got to go through the surgical sieve, looking at the differential diagnosis. You've got to start your way with the basic investigation. Start off with bloods, usual FBC, ELFT, CRP, TSH, B12, folate, iron studies. There's heaps more. I'm not going to give you an exhaustive list. You can look these things up. You should know them, really have a good idea which way you're going. Don't forget to do a urine analysis always, because an occult UTI can always cause an acute delirium. As can any infection, so again on your differential diagnosis, looking for any other symptoms to hint of an occult infection which could be causing this problem. Once you've done that, then you're looking at doing some imaging, looking in the next level of tests, and it gets this issue of can you manage this with a patient where they are, or do they need to be transferred to a hospital? And again, with a confused patient, that's really quite tricky because they might be managing just at home, but you put them in a ward situation, they're going to be really bad and uncontrollable, and you're actually compounding the problem. This sort of links into the more chronic confusion, really looking at dementia. And this is a huge subject on its own, which I'm not going to really be able to go in a short time, give you an exhaustive list, should I say. But just thinking of reversible causes initially, what's worsened it? Has anything been changed to make them worse? Has any changes happened in the social situation? So again, looking at somebody, what's going on at home, what their carer is doing, has been any change of carers, any change of routine. These are the things that can be fixed relatively simply. For dementia itself, you're looking at getting specialist input, looking for sort of dementia clinics that can be run out of the local hospitals or local specialists, or yourself, if you're doing it, if you haven't got the support of those people, you're going through your differential diagnosis list, sending for more exhaustive tests and imaging, and really looking for a senior doctor for their advice at this point in time.